Es gibt eine Vielzahl von Monitoring-Programmen.
There are a number of monitoring programs that, with luck, will produce statistical series for up to 100 years. The data shows a long-term pattern, but doesn't explain the causes. So experiments are needed in which specific environmental conditions can be changed in order to find the direct link between cause and effect.
Ursache und Wirkung herausfinden kann.
The Global Change Experimental Facility offers scientists a unique insight into the ecosystems of the future. Nowhere else can they study the effects of climate change and land use change experimentally at the same time. Scientists can use the GCEF for at least 15 years. It's one of the largest and most complex ecological research facilities in the world.
In der GCEF werden
five different types of land use have been established at the GCEF: conventional farming, ecological farming, the intensive use of grassland, the extensive use of grassland via mowing, and the extensive use of grassland via grazing. These types of land use are exposed to manipulated climate conditions, which we expect to be prevalent at the end of this century, as well as to current climate conditions. Each combination of land use type and climate is being repeated 5 times so that researchers can make statistically solid and reliable conclusions on the effect of individual experimental factors. The size of the test plots and therefore the entire experiment size is not simply a means to an end. There is a wider scientific context. Many processes and changes in a species community or population, as well as interaction between species, happen across large spaces that can exceed well beyond a few meters. These large areas also allow us to realistically recreate the kind of farming conditions on our test plots that you'd find in an authentic setting.
Wie bei uns auch auf den Versuchsparzellen statt.
The unique design of the facility and the long-term studies it enables are ideal for interdisciplinary research. Scientific topics include microevolution, biodiversity, and soil processes.
One focus of research at the GCEF is the interaction between species. This interaction is crucial because essentially it's where the energy and material flow occurs within an ecological community. Climate change can have a critical effect on this interaction. It's possible, for example, that a rise in temperature and a prolonged growing season could lead to certain plants blossoming earlier in the year. Some plant species may then no longer be in bloom when their pollinators are active.
Klimawandel bedeutet,
climate change means that many areas have lower annual precipitation. That doesn't just mean less annual rainfall, but also a change in pattern throughout the year. That again means dry periods are increasing with ever more dramatic effects. We hope the actual experiments will point us towards new uses of land, but also to the selection of new types of cultivated plants.
Auswahl neuer Arten oder Kulturpflanzensorten.
In our test plots, we simulate two of the phenomena of climate change. The first is a higher average temperature. The second is a different pattern of precipitation, based largely on rainfall occurring outside of the summer growing season. An increase in average temperature is achieved by covering the test plots during night hours with removable roofs and walls. These roofs serve to catch any precipitation during the time we want to reduce its effect on the test plots. And they enable us to collect and use the water for our irrigation sprinklers at other times. The same constructions have been built on the test plots with both the manipulated and unaltered climate, because even on their own, these constructions can have certain microclimatic side effects.
Land use change and climate change are global phenomena. That's why the GCEF attracts scientists from all over the world. The Helmholtz Center for Environmental Research in Halle and Leipzig provides them with access to modern labs for analyzing their samples. Or they can complement their experiments in the field with studies in the controlled environment of the greenhouses.
The GCEF experimental areas are designed so further experiments can be integrated. You can manipulate other factors in order to observe the interaction between land use and other environmental changes. This long-term approach also opens up the prospect of long-term involvement and finding realistic answers to your questions.
Damit realistische Antworten auf seine Fragen erhalten zu können.
Only large-scale projects like this offer the infrastructure to bring together scientists from different fields of research. Together, they can make realistic predictions on how anthropogenic changes of the environment affect the functioning of ecosystems. And only this kind of comprehensive study will serve to provide politicians with realistic information.
Politik braucht Informationen.
Politicians need information and verified conclusions on the effects of changes in climate and land use. The experimental facility can help us clarify a series of issues that are relevant to both agricultural and environmental protection policies.
The
environment changes in a variety of ways. Our actions today will have powerful effects on the functioning and performance of our ecosystems in the future. The Global Change Experimental Facility opens up a new world of ways to research and understand the complex interactions in our environment for the long-term protection of our natural resources.